Hi everyone. You can have an HMI on your Android device to monitor and control your Arduino PLC with Bluetooth mode bus communication. The HC05 Bluetooth model default baud rate is 9600. It will first be changed to correspond to that of the Arduino PLC of 115200 using the CoolTerm Terminal application. Download and extract CoolTerm from the link in the description. This USB to TTL converter, which uses the same CH340 device driver as the Nano, is required to connect the model to the computer. Connect the 5-volt red wire of the USB to TTL converter to the VCC pin of the HC05 model. The GND black wire to the model GND. The RX white wire to the model TXD pin and the TX green wire to the model RXD pin. Hold down the push button switch of the HC05 model and plug the converter into the USB port of your computer. Then release the switch. The LED on the model will start blinking slowly. This is an indication that the model is now in AT command mode. Double-click on the CoolTerm application icon. Click on the Option button from the toolbar. Ensure that the correct port is selected. Select the baud rate of 38400. Click on the Terminal option on the left. Ensure that CRO plus LF is selected. Select Local Echo and click OK. Click on the Connect button to establish communication with the Bluetooth model. Type 80 and press Enter to verify the communication. An OK response provides confirmation. Then type 80 plus UART equal 115200,000. Open the PLC program from the last video in ALTC Studio. Upload it into the ALTC PLC with the settings of Nano V5, the port number, a baud rate of 115200, and modbus address of 1. The Bluetooth model will replace the TTL to RS485 model in the circuit connection from the last video. Connect the Bluetooth model TXD pin to the RX pin of the PLC. Its RSD pin to the TX pin of the PLC. VCC to 5 volts and GND to GND. Pair your Android phone with the Bluetooth model using the password 1234. Then download the HMI Modbus app from Play Store. Create a new project with the name Bluetooth Modbus. Touch the three vertical dots at the top right and select Edit Servers List. Touch the three vertical dots at the top right again and select Add Bluetooth Device. Select the paired HC05 model which appears on the screen. Then go back to the main screen. Touch the plus symbol below to add elements. Touch the text and bars tab and drag a label into the screen. Touch the label and select Element Settings. Select Label Settings and then Label. Change the label to Temperature. Select Font Size and change it to 60. Go back to the screen. Touch the temperature label and select the Copy Element option. Touch the copied temperature label. Select Quick Settings and change the label to High Set Points. Copy this label and change it to Low Set Points. Now, drag a NUM input from the Text and Bars tab and place it before the temperature label. From the Element Settings and Label Settings, remove the default label and change the font size to 60. Go back and touch the NUM input. Select Choose Server and then the HC05 server. touch the NUM input again and select Communication Configure. Change the communication address to 0, corresponding to I.1 temperature variable in the PLC. Change the PLC number to 1, which is the PLC mode bus address. Select Input Settings. Change the minimum value to 0 and the maximum value to 150. Change the request type to int16 and ensure that the function code is read only registers 0x03. Go to the main screen. Copy the NUM input. Drag and place it before the high set point. Touch it and select PLC-1 3x0 int16. Change the communication address to 2 and enable allow write request for changing of the set point. Copy the high set point NUM input and place it before the low set point label. Change the communication address to 1 from the quick settings option. To add digital input output elements, copy the load set point label and change it to arrow.1 from the quick settings option. Repeat copy to add labels for arrow.2 and b.2. Place a red indicator from the switch tab before arrow.1 and choose the HC05 server. From the quick settings, change the request to read bit state switch, the PLC number to 1, and leave the address at 0, corresponding to arrow.1 in the PLC. Place an orange indicator before arrow.2. Choose the server. Change the request to read bit state switch. Set the PLC number to 1 and change the address to 1. Place a green indicator before B.2 and repeat the previous steps with the address set to 129. Lastly, add switch 1 from the switches tab and choose the server. From the element settings, change the label to B.1. The label for onState to B.1 and the font size to 60. Select the Communication Configure option. Change the communication address to 128 corresponding to B.1 in OutCPLC. Allow write request and change the request type to set momentary. Ensure that the function code is read coil status 0x01. And go back to the main screen. Touch the triangle play button to enable communication between the HMI and the PLC. Observe that the Bluetooth module fast blinking LED starts blinking slow when communication is established. The temperature and set point values are now being displayed on the Android HMI. Touch the NUM input to change the high and low set points. Press B.1 button to start the flashing of the arrow.2 orange indicator and again to stop it. Thanks for watching. Hit the like button if this video is helpful and drop your thoughts in the comment section. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you are new to this channel and the bell next to it. See you in the next video.